Did you know that 10 years ago, nearly 5,000 people were dying of a deadly disease caused by them being given antibiotics? The disease is called Clostridium difficile diarrhea, and it's a direct consequence of them having those antibiotics. I'm Professor Peter Hawkey, Professor of Public Health and Clinical Bacteriology here at the University of Birmingham, and I've been working on C. diff for nearly 40 years. So what is this disease, and why was it so common? Well, back 10 years ago, 60,000 people were catching this disease, spores from the hospital environment, results in profuse diarrhea, and their guts literally falling to pieces. The cure is obviously to stop them getting the spores, and we've been doing a great job of that in the NHS. So we're down to, last year, there were about 13,000 cases. But unfortunately with this disease, not everyone can be treated with special antibiotics, and the response is only about 80%. So 20% of people carry on with this ghastly disease, and about half of those probably go on to die. And as a lot of these patients are elderly, this is a really significant problem. So what do we do to treat people with recurrent C. diff? Well, it's a very, sounds very unpleasant treatment called faecal microbiome transplantation, where we replace your damaged flora, because that's what's happened to your gut flora. The antibiotics have destroyed a lot of the balance of bacteria in your gut, and this horrible bacterium called Clostridium difficile, Daily Mail called it C. diff, nice catchy title, moves in, produces a horrible toxin substance that damages your bowel. So we can give you a faecal transplant. But the problem is you could catch all sorts of horrible diseases from those faeces. So here at the University of Birmingham, we've developed England's first fully licensed service. So we're making faeces as a true medicine under control of the MHRA regulatory body, which seems a bit counterintuitive. So we're making these lovely pure faeces to put your flora back and to get rid of the C. diff in these people who've relapsed. How do we do it? We have volunteers, people who are very, very fit. We screen them very carefully for any unpleasant diseases. They collect the faeces and we process them in a sterile laboratory setting, and we wind up with this, pure faeces. So this is a medicine, believe it or not, just like your antibiotics, just like your aspirins. How do we give it? Well, under supervision of a gastroenterologist or a microbiologist in the appropriate NHS trust where this poor person is dying of C. diff, we send them, using blood bikes, great charity, they support us free of charge, this sample. And when it's thawed out, when they arrive, the team at the hospital will have popped down one of these, a nasogastric tube, which will just be put through the nose down into the stomach, painless and great. We draw up the substance, the feces, into a syringe, squirt it down. You may say, well, I can taste it. No, nobody tastes it, it's straight into the stomach, and their symptoms usually resolve in 24 to 48 hours. I have a cure rate of over 90%. So it's a great, great treatment. And we're very pleased we've done over 300 now here in Birmingham for various hospitals around England. What backs it up? Our research. As I say, I've been working on C. diff for 40 years. We've got lots of integrated research looking at the way, what sort of bacteria get lost by the antibiotics and how the C. diff does or doesn't interfere with those. But also there's some suggestions that actually we can use faecal transplantation to treat inflammatory disease of the bowel like ulcerative colitis. And I'm involved in a very big study called Stop Colitis, based here in Birmingham, Glasgow and London, which is going to try and work out how efficient faecal transplant is at curing ulcerative colitis. So this is really exciting. There may be other indications for faecal transplantation in the future. But the great thing here at the University of Birmingham is we have established a really good facility for preparing this pure faeces from normal people to enable those who've had their microbiome disrupted by antibiotics or other factors to be replaced with class 1 bacteria from the Midlands. So thank you very much for listening. And if you're interested in faecal transplantation, there's a lot of information online, but we also have a website here at the University of Birmingham, which you can log into. And if you have a relative or a friend who's suffering from severe recurrent disease, then maybe they or their relatives can suggest to the consultants looking after them in hospital that they might wish to consider faecal transplant, in which case those professionals can get in touch with the professionals here at the University of Birmingham, perhaps to arrange a transplant. Thank you and goodbye.